Today, we start our look at the 12 classes available to you, the player. What it means to play that class. The races that allow your class option. And lastly, the benefits and features of your chosen class up to second level. So if you're ready, here we go. Welcome back. Glad you can make it to Basically Speaking on Thinkos Factor. If you like my content, give me a big thumbs up. Tell me about it in the comments below. Also, I take requests for future video ideas. By subscribing, of course, you will be notified if you hit that bell icon when I put up a new video. Now, here's a disclaimer. Character subclasses, colleges, domains, paths, schools, etc. will be covered in separate videos dedicated strictly to that subclass, which I will obviously post a link to the proper class that they're about when it becomes available. Also, at the end of this presentation, I'm going to be putting up a specific link to a special video where I show you an over-the-shoulder quick build of this feature class, covering what I've explained just up to this point, using reference printouts, of course, from Player's Handbook that I've made, and a character record sheet. Our primary focus in this video is going to be about barbarians. What's the first thing that comes to your mind when I mention barbarians? Tell me in those comments below. I really want to know. Back in AD&D, barbarians started out simply as men who were stronger than the average player character, and most of the time were an antagonistic lackey of lower than average intelligence. Today, in the Forgotten Realms, barbarians are looked at as strong-willed tribesmen who are on a personal journey to bring honor to both clan and family. You end up leaving behind all your close-knit ties to go forth to forge new ones. Soon, over time, you will learn to trust a select few adventurers, for they are also on a personal journey of their own. As a barbarian, you have a driving force that dwells within your spirit. To deny your spirit this freedom is like holding back one's inner animal. Of course, this is like admitting defeat, right? Your determination and focus are instinct. Your freedom is the very fuel that harnesses your rage. Chaos is the monster that brings this rage out, causing you to, at times, become superhuman in strength. Your fighter skills are just as good as any, if not better, than most brawlers out there. You are the best of the best that your clan can offer. Honor and pride keep you searching to hone your fighting skills, proving yourself every time you go into battle. Barbarians prefer a lifestyle away from the comforts of city life, and you really distance yourself from crowds. While in the cities, whenever you have to go there, you are always looking over your shoulders. These situations tend to make you very uncomfortable, and you avoid them at all costs. Now, occasionally, if you're in a tavern or something, you might just happen to get over a scrap. Could be someone spilled a drink on you, or a personal insult. However, not every race can produce a barbarian class. The races that are best suited to carry this honorable title of barbarian are the mountain dwarf, the half-orc, and the human. I feel that this is determined strictly by body mass and the ability to make a powerful hit or swing with a battle axe or a greatsword. If you remember when I discussed races and ability bonuses, the mountain dwarf gets a +2 to both constitution and strength. Half-orc gets a +1 to their constitution and a +2 to their strength. And humans get a +1 to all their abilities. Now, this is where things start to get a little confusing for new players. I will try to give my best explanation that I can here. And honestly, if you have any questions, do not hesitate to ask them. I believe that the only stupid question is the one that goes unasked. Because of the features and benefits of of being a barbarian. You have the best hit die of all the classes. You roll a d12 and add your constitution modifier. So, at first level, you can get anywhere between 13 and 16 hit points. Not bad for a first level character. Now that's not all. Each time you level, you roll a d12 and also add your constitution modifier for that, which could give you up to 16 additional hit points every time you level. You're also able to wear light to medium armor and even carry a shield. Now, before I continue, I should explain to you your armor options and how this affects your armor class. If you go for the no armor option, you take a base 10 armor class, add both your dexterity and constitution modifier to that. All other armor options have a number assigned to them, ranging from 11 to 15. For light armor, you add your dexterity modifier to the armor class value, which will determine your end result armor class. For medium armor, you can only add a maximum of 2 from your dexterity modifier. It might not make much sense to you right now, but the more we get into the player's handbook and get to the armor section, you'll begin to understand. It has been my experience that the less restriction a barbarian has, the better. Your weapons are simple and martial. Normally, you get to choose from great axe, 2-hand axes, or an everyday carry weapon. Either way, you also get 4 javelins to start with. Your ability proficiencies are in strength and constitution. Your skill proficiencies are chosen from 2 of the following: animal handling, athletics, intimidation, nature, perception, and survival. It is suggested that you also start out with an explorer's pack, but you do have other options available to you, which I will cover when I get into equipment. Now, starting at first level, your greatest feature of being a barbarian is that you're able to go into a state of rage as a bonus action, providing that you aren't wearing any heavy armor. Here you get the following 3 bonuses. First, you get advantage on strength-based saving throws. That's where you throw 2d20 and take the highest number. Next, when you attack with your strength-based melee weapon, say a great axe for example, you receive bonus damage. This bonus increases as you level. So you start off with a +2 from levels 1 to 8, a +3 from levels 9 to 15, and a +4 from levels 16 to 20. Now lastly, you also gain resistances to bludgeoning, piercing, slashing damage against your person. Now of course, your rage only lasts for 1 minute, which is equal to, I believe, 10 rounds. All the parties involved in the game. Unless, of course, you are knocked unconscious, you haven't attacked an enemy target when your turn ends, or you take damage. Also, as a bonus action, your next turn, you can choose to end your rage. Now, at second level, you gain reckless attack and danger sense. With reckless attack, you toss aside all concern of your personal defense and fiercely attack your opponent. Here's the outcome from this. On your turn, when you attack, you get advantage on your melee attack with your strength-based weapon, of course. Now on the downside, attacks against you will also receive advantage. This feature is what I call a double-edged sword. Now what I mean by this is you have a better chance to strike your opponent, but at the same time, they've also got a better chance to strike you. And with your danger sense, you can tell when something just isn't right with your current situation, giving you the advantage on dexterity-based saving throws. allowing you the chance to dodge any effects you can see, such as traps and spells that are being cast in your direction. So basically, your spidey sense starts tingling when you're in danger. Now, at third level, you're able to choose a primal path and gain other features, which, like I said, I'm going to cover with the primal path videos for the barbarian. Right up here is a link to my over-the-shoulder barbarian quick build video. Here is where I show you how I arrange my ability rolls and select the skills for my mountain dwarf barbarian that I rolled. This will be the same for you when you take your first steps at rolling your barbarian character. I had a great time talking to you about this powerful class, and hope that you enjoy playing your barbarian character. So, until next time, class dismissed.